Hey, what's up guys? Jeremy here. Grippers come in a wide variety of shapes and sizes. And most of the time, the fingers will be custom made for the specific project you're working on. To make sure you can simulate your specific gripper, RoboDK lets you create your own custom end of arm tooling in just a few steps. Let's go through those together. The first step to create a gripper is to import a 3D model. I will drag and drop the step file to load it in my station. I grabbed these 3D models directly from the supplier's website, so you should be able to do the same. I'm using a step file, but IGES or STL would also work. I can open the mechanism builder, so utilities and model mechanism or robot. The default option should be the one to create a linear rail, but in this case, we want the two fingers gripper. Here you have all the indications and steps you need to follow. If you look at the image, it shows you how the base and the fingers should be positioned. In the case of a gripper, the fingers will move along the X axis. FB for frame base. Frame base will be aligned with the zero position of the gripper. We will be able to add a name to our mechanism here. Here we will select our base frame. I'll talk more on that in a few minutes. And finally, you can add the 3D model of the gripper here and the motion direction and limits here. For the 3D model, there are three drop-down menus. So this means we need three geometries or three objects here. In this case, we need the main body of the gripper and both fingers. As we already have that in our station, we can get started. Let's name the mechanism gripper. Okay. Now we need to position our base frame. My base frame should be right in the middle of this surface here, so below the gripper. I'll create one and name it frame base. The next step would be to ensure the frame I just created is positioned according to the image here. In this case, it's simple. The gripper is properly positioned at the origin of the station, so I can simply bring the new reference frame to 000XYZ. Okay, now everything should perfectly match. That's cool. We can then select our frame base here and the gripper 3D models here. Okay, with the fingers. If there is one thing you should do to simplify your way forward, is to position your gripper fingers at their zero position. In this case, if I want the zero to be in the middle, I will move the fingers towards the middle until they touch. So it's 40 millimeters for this one and minus 40 for the other one. Just like that, it should work perfectly. Now I can enter the gripper range of motion. Most likely, if you put the fingers 3D model at the zero position, minimum limit will be zero and the maximum limit will be related to the gripper stroke. In this case, the maximum distance between the two fingers is 80 millimeters. As the default open close ratio is 0.5, I need to enter 80 millimeters here, as this means each finger will travel half that distance, so 40 millimeters each. If instead you want to use the position of one finger with respect to the center of the gripper as your positioning value, you can change the ratio to 1 and enter the maximum stroke of one finger here, so 40 millimeters. But I prefer honestly the first option. Let's update that gripper and test it out a bit. RoboDK will automatically create a duplicate of the reference 3D model you imported so that you can reuse them in the future if you ever need it. But for now, I'll just hide them. Okay, that looks great. Make sure it moves in the right direction and just make sure the limits are also good. If I'm fine with the result, I can press OK on the model mechanism window. So just like that, in a few minutes, you can create any gripper you want. So that's super cool. You can then save it as a .robot file and load it in any other RoboDK station in the future. One quick tip before we leave, if you use your gripper for pick and place application, don't forget to create a TCP for the robot itself, as you can't attach any object to the gripper mechanism itself. You really need a standard TCP to do so. That's pretty much everything for today's video. I hope you liked it. If you did, please subscribe to our channel. This way you won't miss any new tips or walkthroughs. If you have any technical questions, you should definitely visit our online forum. Our team will be happy to interact with you. In any case, have a great day, guys.